Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise Ahaya, everybody. Praise Ahaya one more time. Praise Ahaya, from whom all blessings flow. Amen and amen. This is your sister, Carrie Ann, in Yes Haya, the Christ. Yes Haya of Nazareth. Yes Haya, the Messiah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Okay, brothers and sisters, I want to give this vision, this very, very powerful prophetic vision that the Most High gave me around about the 13th of December 2021. Brothers and sisters, I'm going to head straight into this vision. In this vision, I was in my local supermarket. Let me just make a side note here. Let me make a side note here. And I know some of you already know this, but some of these supermarkets, brothers and sisters, are Masons. They're in the Illuminati. They're sold out to Satan. I just want to get that out of the way, because they are. Some of these big stores and all of that. They are definitely. I know a few. I cover myself underneath the blood. I pray over everything. All right. But yes, they're sold out. But anyways, brothers and sisters, I was in my local, I'm not going to name it, my local supermarket. Okay. And when I went in, it was like, let me, because the timing is important. It was night. This vision was a night vision, brothers and sisters. It was a night vision. When I went into my local supermarket, and straight away when you go in, you can see, you know, down the aisle where the foods or vegetables or whatever is. And when I walk into my supermarket, brothers and sisters, I notice one of the aisles completely empty. Not shelf. Not just one little shelf, the whole entire aisle, a complete, nothing was on there. And it was about, this aisle was about 60 yards long, I would say, or 70 or something like that. And from left aisle to the right, left shelves to the right shelves, nothing was on there, completely empty. I began to look around the supermarket, brothers and sisters, and I noticed that apart from this completely empty aisle, all the aisles were empty, but they had little tip of food, far few and in between. Maybe a 3 packet of pasta there, a 2 packets of rice, a couple packets of sugar, a couple packets of oil, you know, stuff like that. And when I went into the freezer, it was the same thing. It was very scarcely scattered. Food were gone. I then went around to the food, because I'm checking out what's going on, because my mouth was like, you know, I just couldn't believe what I was seeing. I know the food shortages and stuff were coming, but it will happen so quickly in the vision, brothers and sisters. Like, I'm going to the supermarket expecting to buy stuff and everything is gone. I remember in the vision, I went around to a section, and in my local supermarket, this section doesn't exist. It doesn't exist. But in the vision, it existed. And I believe that this is something that is going to come, that the Lord is showing me in the vision, that daughter, this is how they're going to set this up in their local supermarkets. In your local supermarket, you go, you pick up your fruit, you pick up your vegetables, it's already priced, everything is priced, you throw it in your basket. With the fruits and veg, brothers and sisters, it wasn't so. Because in this vision, when I went around to the fruits and vegetable section, there was a counter. This doesn't exist in the local supermarket that I go to. So this is something new that they're going to come, but the Lord is showing me. So when I went around to the fruits and vegetable section, brothers and sisters, all the fruits, well, the little that's there, it was behind a counter. And a guy was selling. He was literally selling the fruit. You know, like when you go to your fruits market, isn't it? When you go to your market, your marketplace, and the people are selling the food, and you can say to them, give me 3 apples, give me 3 fingers of banana, and the man or the woman breaks, and they give it to you, and then you pay them the money. Well, it was like this. And I was taken back, because I was saying to myself, whoa, this is like a marketplace. And everybody were mumbling. We're all in line and people are mumbling and they're complaining. And we're like saying, this has never happened before in the UK in a supermarket. That we were saying. Never happened before in the UK in a supermarket. We normally go, we pick up our stuff, we put it in the basket and we go to the cashier and we're gone. But now we've got to go to this counter and tell the guy exactly what we want. But the guy was rationing. So you couldn't get one full bunch of banana. Banana was there, but it was like two or three hand of banana, two apples, a handful of grape. Everything was just ration. So nothing in terms of the fruits and veg was left off. Brothers and sisters, you have to go to this counter and go up with your money to buy, and you couldn't get the full stuff of what you want because the guy was telling us, oh, we're very, very short. We're short in this. I'm sorry, you cannot have so much apples. You cannot have so much broccoli. You're going to have a little piece. And it was horrible because some people got big family. And you just think, and people were just so dismayed. I didn't buy anything because I understood what was going on. I think the Lord just wanted to show me what was going on and what is to come in some of these supermarkets. That the time is coming, brothers and sisters, where things are going to be so scarce that they're going to set up counters and shelves in the supermarket. That's never happened before. Well, maybe in the olden days, but that's how they're going to do it. They're going to set up counters and shelves with people literally behind it. And you have to tell them what you want. And if you go and say, can I have, I don't know, 2 pounds of flour, they might say, I'm sorry, you can't get 2 pounds. We can give you half a pound. That is how bad it's going to be. Father, you're in control. The vision is true. All right. So watch this now, brothers and sisters. Watch this. So I left out the line because I didn't buy anything. And I went back to the same place where I was before, where the aisle is completely empty. No food or anything. And I just walked off a little bit because I'm just noticing what's going on in this place, brothers and sisters. And in the vision, all the supermarket workers were running up and down. But I couldn't understand. They were in a frantic. But I couldn't understand at the time why they were running up and down. They were running up and down frantically, but I just couldn't understand. But over under the section of the supermarket, the only thing that was prominent was clothing. you can get any amount of clothes that you want. Clothing. People didn't want clothing, brothers and sisters. They need food. And that was what was scarce. So I went back again. And I stood exactly just looking at what was going on this aisle. Because this is the aisle where people were just running, these supermarket workers, up and down frantically with paper and pen. I couldn't understand. I'm going to tell you why they were doing it. I'm going to tell you why, don't worry. I just couldn't understand. So as I stood there, brothers and sisters, I saw a lady, one of the supermarket workers came. And she had like a electrical cord in her hands, wrapped up. It was all reeled up in her hands. But it was like it was attached to the plug in the wall. I then saw a writing, like it wasn't digital or anything. It probably was there, but I just didn't see it. But all of a sudden, on a piece of cardboard, there was a writing, like an announcement for the people in the supermarket, for us, the customers. And I began to take out my phone. But every time I take out my phone, because I said, I'm going to put this on YouTube. I'm going to do my YouTube video to show brothers and sisters that the supermarket aisles were empty. But every time I take out my video, brothers and sisters, it's like because people were running up and down, I couldn't do it because I didn't want to capture them in the video. So I just couldn't get to take a picture to a video of what was going on. When I eventually spot this plaque or cardboard with some writing on it, brothers and sisters, listen to this very, very carefully. I saw the writing, something, I'm only paraphrasing now, okay? But I saw the writing, something in the lines of, If you want to know why we have food shortages, go and contact the United Nations, the UN. That was the writing. Vision is true. Vision is true, brothers and sisters. That was the writing that I saw. It wasn't there before. I didn't see it before, but then all of a sudden it came on a like a plaque or a cardboard. And it just say, I'm paraphrasing, but that's what it says. If you want to know why we have food shortages, go and contact the United Nations. They're sending people to ask the United Nations, the UN, why we have food shortages. Vision is plain, isn't it? I then saw another plaque came in front, and I saw March 6 stroke 7. I didn't see any year. I didn't see any year, but I saw March 6 stroke 7. The lady that I said to you that had the electric cord reeled up in her hands and it was still plugged. She then plugged out, she pulled out the electric cord from the socket and the whole place went dark. Electric went. And then she went, oh, I'm so sorry, I'm so sorry, I've made a mistake. This is one of the supermarket workers. She went, oh, I'm so sorry, everybody, I've made a mistake. I plug it back in. That's what she said. Brothers and sisters, when she plugged the electric cord back into the socket and we had light again. I don't know where they came from because they weren't there. I saw doctors and nurses in the supermarket on the empty aisles looking after patients on these in these empty aisles, brothers and sisters, where there were no food. And I was astonished. And I begin now to say, okay, this is the reason why. The supermarket workers were running up and down. They were preparing because they knew that they were going to use the empty aisles to nurse these sick patients that's coming in. So I begin to walk and I went to the lady actually that pulled the socket out, the electric cord out of the socket. And I said to her, why these doctors? Oh, it's so new. I said, why these doctors and nurses? Why would we have sick patients in the supermarket? And she said, oh, the hospitals are overflow. And because we do not have enough food, we're using the empty aisles to look after patients. Are you listening to the vision, brothers and sisters? Are you listening to the vision? Supermarkets turning empty, empty supermarkets turning into hospitals because the literal hospitals that they have is overflow. I begin to walk up to these patients because remember, they all appeared. I don't know where they, well, they all appeared, isn't it? Once you plug the light, the thingy out, and the light came back. They all appeared. And some of them were dead because they were in body bags, brothers and sisters. And these doctors or nurses, they were trying so hard to save these patients. They were sick, proper sick. And when I look at the door entrance, we're walking to come into this supermarket, you see families and friends, because now people in the community have heard that the supermarket has turned into a mini hospitals. So now they could bring their sick one here to the supermarket because the hospital itself will overflow, it will fall, can't cope. Brothers and sisters, let me tell you something. It was still night and it was cold because I saw people in the jacket. When I tell you, listen to me very carefully. When I tell you that these patients were sick, I mean they were proper, they were next to death. This is how sick they were. This is how sick they were. I saw one lady, maybe it's her husband, that was bringing her in the supermarket. She just looked like death warmed up. so bad. So, so bad. But I wasn't allowed to help. Because normally in the medical vision that I get, I always help out. But in this one, I didn't see myself helping at all. I was just observing what was going on. And like I say, all these doctors and nurses, they were trying the best to save as many patients. There was an outbreak. That's the word I'm looking for. There was an outbreak, brothers and sisters. The people were so weak. They were so weak. Very, very weak. But it was made known to me in the vision, brothers and sisters. Omicron came up in the vision. Omicron came up in the vision that they were blamed. Hallelujah, Father. I thank you for the prophetic because I've been warning. Because in the vision, they were blaming it on Omicron. But because I knew better, I knew when I saw these things happening, I knew it was eating the pudding. It was now manifesting and having an effect on these people's immunity. That's what it was doing. They were so sick. It was so sad, brothers and sisters. And I higher bless all these nurses and doctors because they were working so hard. They were I saw it for myself. These doctors and nurses, they were working hard. And they were trying to save as much as they could. But the people, they were weak. That's the prominence in this vision, brothers and sisters. They were weak. When I say weak, there was the lady. She could hardly walk. She could hardly walk. She just wanted to lay down. These dirty, wicked, pharaotic Caesars. I don't know. Their judgment is coming. And it's going to be harsh for what they've done to the people. Very, very wicked. Very wicked. But you see, some of them are fallen angels. They're not human. So because they're fallen angels, and some of them are demonic. They're humans, but they're demonic, right? And they're working for the kingdom of darkness. And this is why you need Christ. You're going to need him, brothers and sisters, in these end days. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Yes, Higher warned us. He says that the things coming upon this earth as never, ever, ever, ever seen or been or ever happened in the history of the human race. So what the Lord is saying from the time the creation of Adam and Eve, and Adam and Eve is not a clone like some people are promoting on their stupid YouTube channel. They're not a clone. Devil is a liar. The first human being that a higher created, Adam and Eve. What Yesaya is saying from the time of Adam and Eve up until this dispensation in 2021, what we're about to see has never ever happened in the history of the human race. So you must know that what Yesaya is saying is going to be bad. This vision is just a drop in the water. This is just a little needle in the haystack of what is to come. But Ahaya is showing you and he's telling you that the slices of the pudding is very, very wicked. I did that video, didn't I? And I left the link on my website. Go check out my website for the link of the guy, the funeral guy, who sees the passing away coming in into his funeral home. Go watch that video because he's 150% right. The vision is true. The vision is true. These people are just the weak brothers and sisters. We have that to contend with. We've got the zumzums to contend with. All sorts of wickedness just because of the eating the pudding. That's all that one is. These people have created this. Very, very evil. But I wanted to come and release this prophetic vision, all right? So be bold, be strong, be courageous. Walk with Ahaya, just like Enoch. All praises, all beautiful praises to the Most High Ahaya, who lives above the heavens. I eternally bless you. I love you all, and I will see you soon someday in glory. In yes, highest holy name, amen and amen. Let us say the benediction together. It's Jude chapter 1, verses 24 to 25. The Bible reads, "Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise, yes, higher, or Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power both now and forever." Amen and amen. Let's say the benediction together. The benediction is Jude chapter 1, verses 24 to 25 of the Bible reads, "Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise, yes, higher, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever." Amen and amen. Amen. Blessings. Amen.